Have you ever wondered what it's like to start a van conversion business? Well, Gretchen and Taylor did just that. In 2020, their revenue was $800,000, and this year they're projected to do $3 million. Stick around to find out how. On this episode, we're featuring Gretchen Bayless and Taylor Hood, who started Access Vehicles in 2020. Their first year, they booked three times their renters than they expected, so they need to expand their fleet, so they started their own. Now, they build, sell, and rent these vans to outdoor enthusiasts. Tell us, in a nutshell, the whole process of getting the van to having it completed. How much does it cost to build a van like this? Should they do both, build and rent? On this episode, you guys are going to learn how they took their love for the outdoors and turned it into a profitable business. We're going to talk about marketing, starting the business, how to reduce costs, and a lot more. So on each van, what's the expected profit?
We try to work on two vans at a time. Right now, we have three vans in the bay. $80,000 to $100,000 of expenses, just kind of revolving.
You guys, make sure you subscribe to our channel, throw us a like real quick, and let's go meet Gretchen and Taylor. Gretchen, tell us a little bit about you, Taylor, and what led you to starting Access Vehicles.
Sure. So what led us to Access Vehicles was needing to build vans for our rental fleet for Roamerica. We needed durable, clearly, because it was a rental. Mm-hmm. So it needed to be able to be beat up and still survive a rental season. So we started building our own vans. We saw a need for it in the market to get into a durable, high-quality rig at a reasonable price. Especially for families of four or five. So we just started building our own vans.
Outdoor. You guys are outdoor people.
Try to be.
Did that play a big role?
Huge role, because we're always in our van. We have two little kids, two old dogs. And the old dogs is a big one, because they have to be comfortable, probably more so than even our kids need to be comfortable. Mm-hmm. And we have to stay sane. So we are in our van and outside as much as possible. And so we're always trying new things on our own van, which leads us to put them either into the rental fleet vans or the customer builds or not, depending on how they survive.
Well, let's take a look at your operation. Great. In the shop. Go ahead and show us kind of what things look like. And
sure.
Then maybe we'll head on to the second phase of what the vans look like after they look like this.
All right.
How many square feet do you have here, Gretchen?
This is 2,500 square feet. We try to work on two vans at a time. Right now, we have three vans in the bay.
Getting a little tight.
Yeah, but you know, they're just finalizing a couple details on this one van.
Mm-hmm.
And then the van with the Colorado plates, that's just getting some accessories added on. That was purchased from us last year. Mm-hmm. So now it's coming back for rack, awning, ladder, heater.
Can we take a look?
Yeah.
Just all the details you're talking about?
Yeah.
Kind of how things are lined out. I guess since we're walking in, Gretchen, what are we looking at here? Do you build everything from scratch for the inside of the van?
So it's assembled here. This is kind of like our assembly table. So this has all been pieced together. So all this aluminum framing is built here. You know, the 80-20 gets delivered. We assemble mm-hmm. it and cut it to size. So this is the cabinet that goes in most of the vans, all the vans' layouts.
Okay.
The customers get to pick the finishes. This customer picked this nice black finish. And then as you see, these are placed right now to just kind of line up the heater, the water pump, USB port, fridge, and then these are the kitchen drawers here.
This is pretty much the length of the van, right?
Exactly.
I guess we're going to see in the other vans that have this installed already. But
yep, come on back.
Do you do this as well? Is this for the van or?
That's for the van. Yep.
Very
That's
cool.
The kitchen countertop. You'll
Makes
see.
Makes it feel homey.
Yeah, so this one's actually, Taylor's working on this right now, getting a heater installed. Again, this is an older build of ours where the customer brought it back.
May I open it?
Did a couple things. Yep, just watch out behind you.
Yep. So you've got a bed up on top.
Yes.
How many people does it sleep?
This one sleeps four to five. They have two kids. So they have two up top, and then there's a bench seat, this guy here,
mm-hmm.
That goes down below, and with lap belts for the kids. And then the heater's getting installed there. I got a tire rack, and then the spare tire will go on the back.
How much does it cost to build a van like this in general?
Yeah, in general, it's from about $80,000 to $100,000, and that's van included and typically four-wheel drive.
Gotcha. Okay. And do you buy them all-wheel drive, four-wheel drive, or do you do some conversions?
So we do some, well, we personally don't do the four-wheel drive conversions. We partner with a company, Quad Van, in Portland for those. So mm-hmm. we can buy a two-wheel drive vehicle, ship it out to Quad Van, and they do the four-wheel drive conversion, or we purchase all-wheel drive for our customers. It's just kind of a customer preference. Mm-hmm. And we talk the customer through it. We walk them through all mm-hmm. the options, find out their driving capabilities, what they're wanting to do with the rig, and then we kind of help kind of guide them to the right option.
So if I wanted to come in and I'm not in a position to buy one of these vans, yep. can I rent an Access van?
You sure can.
Tell us the cost and where do we go to do that?
Yeah, so you go through our sister company, Roamerica, and we offer Access vans to rent. They're about $300 a night, and that's four-wheel drive, totally kitted out, has mm-hmm. all the gear that you'll need for a great camping experience. Again, seats 5. You can sleep that as well, so you can bring friends or your whole family. Dog friendly too, which is nice.
All vans. Extra charge for that?
Nope.
Okay.
It's included. We
the
even
true
have a little
outdoor setup.
Yeah, we even have a little soft crate for the pup to travel safely. And then if you end up buying later on, we'll credit you those rentals.
Okay.
Yeah.
For somebody looking to get into the van conversion business, how important is it to partner up, or should they do both, build and rent? What's your take and experience so far?
Take is, you have to have a lot of patience if you're going to want to get into the rental business. Mm-hmm. We love it. I don't know if it's for everybody. We love cleaning vehicles. I don't think everybody does love cleaning vehicles. We grew up, we're both car families, and so we really, really enjoy working on vehicles and cleaning mm-hmm. them and getting ready for customers. We also have kids, and so we have that take on it to where it's like we know how to set up the vehicles for the families that are coming in to rent. Again, not everybody's in that position, so I'm not sure if it's for everybody. Building the vans, it was just kind of a natural progression to do that. So.
I see. Gretchen, tell us, in a nutshell, the whole process of getting the van to having it completed. Break it down in steps.
Sure. So we pick up a van either from private party or a dealership that we work with. Van comes in and we strip the van on the inside. So usually they're cargo vans. Sometimes they're new, sometimes they're used, but they get clean, they get okay. stripped. They come into the bay and there's a build sheet attached to that van because usually it's going to a specific customer.
Can we see an example of one, a build sheet?
We Let have me anything? See if I have one.
Right over there.
Yeah.
I figured, that's why I asked. Let's take a look. Because that's basically what happens once it pulls into the shop. Okay.
Yeah.
So check it out, guys. Here's the build sheet.
We have a few examples. And then we have vans coming in for maintenance. We offer warranty on all of our vehicles. And so they'll come in for, we haven't had any warranty claims, but we have vans come back after 30 days or so, or to get accessories added on. So they get a build sheet as well. While the stage one is happening, which is that first van there. So it's flooring, it's wall panels, insulation, electrical, ceiling, fans, lights. That's the stage one. From stage two, it is assembly of cabinetry and electrical.
Right behind you?
Yep. And then okay. the end of stage two kind of looks like this, even though this van's been taken apart.
Putting it all inside.
Yeah, kind of the final assembly of everything. And then the additional accessories, such as the heater, roof rack, tire rack, ladder, awning, solar. Mm-hmm. And then the customer gets to pick up and take her for a rip.
You guys, just reminding you that this year, 2021, we are releasing our hub, upflip.com/hub, where we're going to have all the information for you on how to start, build, and grow a successful business. Make sure you check it out. We'd love to know what your monthly expenses are, how many employees you have working with you. What does that look like for you at this stage?
Yep. So right now we have 2 employees full-time. We'll be adding a couple more this month. Depends on how many vans are coming through the door. Mm-hmm. Sometimes we buy, you know, a handful of vans at a time. Like you saw out front, we have 3 vans right now that aren't being worked on, but we've purchased the vans. We like to keep a handful of vans inventory in stock. So that way when the van does get pulled in the bay, we have everything in stock. But mm-hmm. You're looking at $80,000 to $100,000 of expenses, just kind of revolving.
Couple of vans and all the materials
yep.
and stuff.
Yep. And then labor and payroll and insurance and starts to add up.
Yeah, you've got the overhead with the rental,
yep,
this lease space right
yep,
here?
Okay. Exactly.
Now, what do you pay for this?
This spot is about 80 cents a square foot.
80 cents, okay.
Yeah.
varies from market to market.
It is, yeah. Like Portland is twice that, right? Hood River County is a little bit less. Mm-hmm. And okay. then if you wanted to see kind of the kitchen yeah. assembly.
Is that how the list
That's how the list
works?
For how the fans. Gotcha. So you'll see that cabinet that's on the table there wow. is the same here, just different finishes.
Look at the finish up on top though. Is that your work as well?
Yep. The there. Lights and the fans. And that's a cedar panel that goes up top.
So what are the basic installs for a van? I see you've got a fridge.
Yep, fridge. And then all the drawers, the kitchen drawers are all full extensions, soft close, super deep. You can house a lot of stuff in there, which is really nice.
Basically have 1, 2, 3, 4 compartments mm-hmm. with...
And then the water, and then all the electrical, everything's wired for solar off the roof or off the side. Again, should you ever want to add solar later on, it's already wired for it. You're not having to open up any walls or anything. It comes with the lights, it comes with the fans, it comes with everything you're going to need to go camping with your family.
That's awesome. These yeah. machines are really, really cool. Gretchen, what are the profits and expenses in this business? Let's just take year two for you.
Yep.
You know, what are the profit margins you could expect that you shoot for? And
so each van costs a lot of money to build. We buy the van for the customer. We outfit it with everything that they're going to want, including the accessories. Our business model is we do take a down payment, which helps, but we don't ask for the entire build to pay paid up front. We want our customers to be happy. So,
how much is the down payment? Just to
get
down
payment is usually about 10 grand.
Okay.
So it's pretty small. Once we buy the van, then the customer purchases the van from us so that they can get it registered, insured on their own end, and that does help cover some of the costs as well.
So on each van, what's the expected profit that you take in?
On average, about 20,000.
Okay.
Yep. And then as a business, we just turn that into the next build or, you know, upfitting our shop with better tools and hiring.
Gotcha. How long does it take to get the van to the completed stage from the moment it's standing yeah. in the parking lot, actually pulls into the shop?
Pulls into the shop.
How many man hours are we talking about?
Man hours. Taylor, man hours.
270.
This is Taylor, by the way, you guys.
How are you doing?
I know.
270.
He knows man hours.
You nailed it, right?
Just, so, I mean, roughly.
Right. Taylor's our numbers
glass,
guy.
Four-wheel drive and heaters mm-hmm. and solar panels and racks and all sorts of stuff. So it really just kind of depends, but... About 270 hours is about right for kind of our standard build.
I'm trying to divide that by weeks. Is one man working usually on the van?
No. Well, that's our team, you know. So
okay.
we've got Gretchen doing a lot of the front end work.
Certain things.
Doing kind of the project management, development, and guiding at the install. We have Nick, who's our lead builder. And then we've got Chris, who's
Nick right there.
Not only our builder, but also our media guy as well.
Mm-hmm.
So... focusing just on the van, just on a standard build, it's an easy 300 hours.
Wow, okay.
Divide that by, I would say, two people dedicated full-time building on the van.
Okay.
And of course, there's support. So
yeah.
There's other things that go on there, but...
Roughly 3 to 4 weeks, though.
Hands
three
on
to
the
four
van.
Weeks, okay.
Yeah, hands on the van. Yeah, 250 to 300 hours, depending on the
accessories.
The build.
Okay. Let's talk about marketing strategies for Access Vehicle. I mean,
sure.
you've used some creative ways to do that. What yeah. are you doing currently? What's working the best?
You know, right now we're not putting any money into paid advertising. We actually have never paid for any advertising in regards to Roamerica or Access. What we like to do is just be a part of the community that we're in.
Hmm.
So Access is in Hood River. We actually just moved here in November. We live here. We've actually lived here for decades, all of us. So
mm-hmm.
it was always a natural thing to be in Hood River, the shop. And so for us, our plans is to just be able to support the community here. And then hopefully we do a good job at that. And people can then start talking about Access in the shop and the fun vans that they get to see be a part of the community.
Well, you've grown from 8 to 30. So what attributed to that? Just you being here, people knowing you, or what
yeah,
else?
Yeah, I think so. And I think it's just also because of the... our business, Roamerica, being able to have the rental vans, the builds, the Access vans be a part of the rental fleet. People are able to try them before they buy them, which
mm-hmm.
is really nice. And if somebody's hesitant about maybe a van, they're not sure if a van's going to be a right fit. Maybe they're also wanting to do an RV or a truck camper, they can try a van, and it's, you know, just a rental cost versus having to buy a $100,000 rig and just be like, oh, it's not for me. Mm-hmm. Granted, we haven't had any customers do that. They always want a van afterwards, but I think it's just a good, it's a good relationship that we have with the business.
Curious about the cost of each van. You mentioned $80,000 to $100,000.
Yep.
Do I, as a customer, have option to customize things? Are you guys more custom versus et cetera?
Those We're are the kind things of in the interest. Middle.
Okay.
So we offer 3 set layouts. Mm-hmm. And with those layouts, you get to pick your finishes, which means you get to pick the color of your floor, your ceiling, your kitchen countertop, your cabinetry color. For example, this van here in the back, mm-hmm. they went with a really nice green upholstery fabric, black floor, and kind of a gray cabinet face, and then a butcher block countertop, which is really nice. It's pretty outdoorsy feel, which is nice. Mm-hmm. And then the cedar panel on the ceiling. So it's really warm and inviting. You'll see kind of on the shelves over there, we have some maroon cushions, some gray cushions. So you definitely get to customize your van in regards to how it looks at the very end, the colors. But we have put all the time needed and all the research into the layout of the van. Mm-hmm. So that's what's going to work best for the majority of customers. And then they get to personalize it to make it feel like their own.
How many options for layout personalization do I have?
So there's 3 layouts that we offer.
Okay.
And then with those 3 layouts, there's typically 3 to 5 different colors you get to choose from.
Have you found one layout to be more in demand than the other? What would be the front runner?
The number one layout is our revolver layout. It's the one with the seat belts in the back. So that way you can have passengers, even if you don't have kids. Most of our folks are using these as everyday drivers. And so if you're going to be picking up mom and dad from the airport one time, you have seat belts in the back seat mm-hmm. for passengers, for friends if you want to take them camping, 2 beds, everything you're going to need, and all the storage too.
How many people would it seat then legally with the
5
seat belts? So 5.
Okay. Yep.
You got 2 in front and 3 in the back.
Correct.
So in starting a van conversion business, what other services do you offer yourself and you would recommend to our viewers who want to get in the same business? What other services can we offer?
Sure. So a lot of our vans are meant to be added onto. So a customer buys a van from us, but they may not need a roof rack right now. So they'll come back in 6 months, maybe when they're planning on taking a big kayaking trip this summer. And so adding accessories at a later date is really nice option to be able to offer customers.
Okay. Is there anything else you do on top of that?
The 4-wheel drive conversions, you know, just partnering with other companies that specialize in that. We don't specialize in 4-wheel drive conversions. We have the capabilities, but it's just not our specialty. So mm-hmm. being able to partner with other companies that offer that is really nice, and being able to offer those warranties to the customers. So again, it's just kind of expanding your partnerships and your networks with companies that you work with. So that way you can offer more services to your customers. So they're not having to do the legwork. You can
That's
do it
awesome.
For them.
Yeah, so if I basically show up to your shop, sounds like I'm not going to get a no, particularly no reason. You've got all the kind of partners lined up to do this, to do that, to do that.
We hope so, and if not, we'll find out for you.
That's a good way to do business. You guys, if we can get 5,000 likes on this video within the first month of its release, we will do an update on Taylor and Gretchen and their business. So make sure you comment below, tell us what else you want us to ask, and we'll do it for you. So make sure you like this video right now. It only takes 2 seconds. In terms of partnering up, what's your suggestion? Where do we go to find the right partners to be in business with?
For us, it was who we use. So mm-hmm. all the gear that we use in our own van and our everyday travels, it's like we just reached out to the customers because we had already been using the gear for decades mm-hmm. and it was still in our van and it had survived Taylor and I adventuring together, our dogs, our kids, and we're like, well, this would make perfect gear to provide in the rentals. So just reaching out to companies and just having that honest conversation with them about how much you love their gear and how it survived your whatever you've done to it. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it's really nice how encouraging just other companies in the outdoor industry are to get product into people's hands.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool group of people, you know, those fans for the outdoors. It's
easygoing.
All like your family,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, it's nice.
Just curious, what are your favorite parts about the van? Features, things personally for you that you really, so cool, you know, kind of deal?
Personally for me, it's the space. It's really deceiving, I feel like. From the outside, it doesn't look like there's much space. But to get inside
Come in inside, take a look.
Be able to stand completely up, I have all my cabinets. They're easy, soft close, like just nice, durable. We can have everything in here. Oops.
Good use of space everywhere. Yeah. Right? Not too cluttered.
And then the sink, all the drawer, everything is just really easy to use, but it's super durable. So even to have our kids in here, this is like full kid zone, which is really nice. And they can just go crazy. The pups can be here. They're not in the way. Everything's also removable too, which is really nice. So everything's just high functioning, I feel like.
You've got this bed. I've seen the other van have a second.
Yes.
So this is just
this is
one
a different
model.
Layout.
Gotcha.
Yep.
Interesting. Yeah. Wow, you could fit quite a bit of people with this and then a second.
Yeah, this bed's
story.
6'11" by 6 feet wide.
Wow.
I know.
It is deceiving. They look a lot smaller from the outside. And is the tire package, the wheels, all part of what you guys do as well?
Typically, yeah. We do give customers options on the tires. Again, it just kind of depends on what they're looking for.
Three words from both of you to our viewers who are just excited about the outdoors, who maybe want to get in the same business. Three words, four words. What's on your mind? And we can talk to them. Anything?
Start now.
Start now. It's a good one.
Every hour wasted is an hour lost. So
I love that.
Yep. Just keep your foot on the gas.
Take the shot. You miss 100% of them.
Yes.
That you don't take.
That you don't take. That's
what about
right.
you, Gretchen?
Just do it. Get started.
Okay.
Might as well. What do you have to lose?
Beautiful.
Maybe everything, but you can always start over.
And that's a wrap. Thank you, guys. It's been a pleasure. You guys got an incredible story, and I love your vans. Maybe one day
Thank
I'm going to rent
you.
One. And take it outdoors. Well, that's a wrap with Access Vehicles. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe to our channel. Like this video if you haven't already. That way you don't miss any of our revenue generating videos from UpFlip. Thank you again.